Hello.
In this video, we will show you how to capture and analyze NetSim packets using Wireshark. With protocols proliferating and becoming more complex, new diagnostic methods are essential. NetSim now enables you to capture packets from inside the simulator as it flows from one node to another using Wireshark, the industry standard network protocol analyzer. Users can create network scenarios across a wide range of protocols in NetSim, model application traffic, and then use Wireshark for post-processing. Let us consider a simple network comprising of 3 routers, 2 switches, and 6 wired nodes. As you can see, we have modeled the network in NetSim by just clicking and dropping the network elements and connecting those using appropriate links. In this network, the application that we have created is CBR from wired node F to wired node K. To enable Wireshark, right-click on the source node, which is wired node F, and set Wireshark option to online in global properties. We then simulate the network for 100 seconds. As you see, once the simulation starts, Wireshark automatically starts and displays all the captured packets. This contains various details like packet number, time, source, destination, protocol, etc. On clicking the packet, the details are displayed in the panes below. The first pane provides the tree view and the second the byte view. In the tree form, we expand the data by clicking on the part of the tree and viewing detailed information about each protocol in the packet. As you see, clicking on transmission control protocol displays source port, destination port, etc. We can filter packets based on protocol, presence of a field, values of fields, etc. Now, to filter ICMP packets, just enter ICMP in the filter and press enter. As you see, ICMP packets are filtered. Let us further filter TCP packets whose SYN flag is set to 1. We just enter tcp.flags.syn == 1 and press enter. All TCP SYN packets are filtered. The traffic between two different endpoints can be analyzed by using conversations. We can further analyze various conversations like TCP conversation, IP conversations, etc. To generate graphs, we go to the statistics menu and select conversations. Different protocols are available. On selecting TCP tab, we have now obtained the TCP conversation. Now on clicking the graph A to B button, our graph is readily plotted and this is a time sequence graph. Using the graph type window, we now change the graph type to throughput and the throughput graph is obtained. On changing the graph type to window scaling, we see the window scaling graph with every minute detail plotted. We have viewed, filtered and generated graphs and now let us compare packet lengths. To do this, we will have to go to the statistics menu and select packet lengths. We can also filter to analyze a collection of specific packets only. Let us filter TCP packets and to do this, we enter TCP and press enter. Now the packet lengths with filtered TCP is displayed. Let us now move on to generating IO graphs. To do this, let us click on statistics and select IO graph. The Wireshark IO graph window is displayed. For better visualization, we will now edit the x-axis tick interval to 0.1 second and pixel per tick to 10. We can analyze up to 5 graphs using the graph filters provided. We now filter TCP SYN, ICMP and IP. To do this, we enter tcp.flags.syn, ICMP, IP in graph 1, graph 2 and graph 3 filters and click on the respective graph buttons. We have now obtained 3 different graphs which are visually differentiated by color. One final feature which would be useful for quickly and easily checking connections between client and server is the flow graph. It can show where there might be issues with a TCP connection, such as timeouts, retransmitted frames, or dropped connections. To obtain this, we go to the statistics menu and select the flow graph option. By default, we see the flow graph of all the packets. To get the TCP flow graph, we select TCP flow and the same is displayed. We hope this video gave you an idea of how to capture and analyze NetSim packets using Wireshark. Thank you for watching.